Topics: Systems Convolution Fourier Series. Systems Convolution Fourier Series, a small revision. So we have in systems, first I will start with systems topic. In systems, what we have? In systems, we have five different classifications. We have five different classifications. First one is static and dynamic. Static dynamic. Second one is linear nonlinear. Linear nonlinear. Third classification is time variant, time invariant, time variant, time invariant. Fourth one is stable unstable, stable and unstable systems. Last one is causal non-causal systems. Causal non-causal systems. So causal means non-anticipatory. Anticipatory means depending on future. And the non-causal means anticipatory, which is depending on future. Anticipatory, which is depending on future. Okay. So I will start one by one. I will start with one by one. I am going to static and dynamic systems. Static and dynamic systems. So static means present output is function of present input. Present output is function of present input alone. Then it is called static system. Then it is called static system. If present output, it is function of past input, future input, also present input. Past, future, all these things comes, then it is dynamic system. So here it needs memory to store all the past and future with memory. The systems are with memory. So such systems are called dynamic system. So static systems are without memory. Static systems are without memory. Or memoryless systems are called static systems. Memoryless systems are called static systems. Okay. And this is about the basic thing. Examples you just check out from our regular discussion. I'm going to the second one, linear and nonlinear. Linear and nonlinear systems. Second classification, linear and nonlinear systems. Just I will give a revise of whatever we have discussed. If y of t equal to x1 of t plus x2 of t, it is nonlinear. It is nonlinear. If y of t equal to a into x of t plus b, this is also nonlinear. This also we have discussed nonlinear. Y of t equal to x square of t, x square of t, this is also nonlinear. Okay. So if you put y, x1, x2, x1 plus x2, first one is linear. So I thought of discussing the third one. I have started like this. First one is linear. You go with our general rule. First one is linear. And if you go with y of t equal to x of t square, this is linear system. In discrete time, same thing you can expect as y of n square, the same thing you can expect as x square of n if question comes like this. Okay, if question comes like this in continuous time, in discrete time, x of n plus b. Okay, so something like that in continuous and discrete time. If you have some other problem, t into x of t, this is also linear. T into x of t, this is also linear. If you have y of t equal to x of t cos omega ct, you follow the long procedure for solving. This is also linear system. This is also linear system. If you have dy of t by dt plus 5 times y of t equal to 2 times x of t, this is a linear system. This is linear system. If you have dy of t by dt plus 5 times y of t plus a constant is also there, this constant always gives nonlinear. When you substitute, you derive it in the long procedure what we have discussed in our regular class. Okay, so based on that you can just understand y of n equal to x of minus n, x of minus n. Okay, so whether it is linear or not, what is our general procedure? In first case we will put x1 of, in second case we will put x2 of, okay, and in third case we will put in the place of x, x1 plus x2 we have to put. This is our equation 1, equation 2, this is equation 3. This we will give y3 of n. RHS alone you just combine equation 1 plus 2, whether it is equal to RHS in equation 3, then it is a linear system. Okay, the question x of minus n is linear. The procedure solution for the last one I have done here. This is the overall procedure. Okay, for finding linear and non-linear. All other things directly from the question I have written whether it is linear or not. Now I am going to the next classification. Static dynamic completed, linear, non-linear completed. I am going to time invariant, time invariant system. And in this the rule is, in linear, non-linear, okay, it has to follow homogeneity plus superposition principle. Homogeneity plus superposition is followed, then it is a linear system. If not followed, that is non-linear system. Now I am going to time invariant and time invariant system. Okay. In this, we will calculate y of t comma tau and y of t minus tau. Here we will put in the full equation. Okay, in the full y of t equation, wherever t is there, we will put t minus tau. In the full equation, delay for input we will create. Okay, after this we will check whether y of t comma tau equal to y of t minus tau. If it is equal, time invariant system. If they are not equal, then it is time variant system. This is our rule. Okay, this is our general rule. And if you take some questions, y of n equal to x of n minus 1, if you follow the full procedure, we have done number of problems on this. If you follow the procedure, this is time invariant system. If you take y of t equal to t into x of t, this is time variant system. And if you take y of n equal to n into x of n, it is the same problem in discrete time. It is time variant. If you take x of k into n, okay, this is also time variant system. Okay, so I will do the solution for the last one. Y of t comma tau means you are delaying only input. So x of kn minus tau will come, one delay will come. Y of t minus tau means wherever, I have to apply the same in terms of n. So y of n comma tau means you are delaying the input. Y of n minus tau means throughout the equation, wherever n is there, that you have to replace with n minus tau. In this case, it becomes x of kn minus k tau. And if you see, this is first equation, second equation, RHS are not equal. N comma tau, it is not equal to n minus tau. Hence it is time variant system. Last one alone I have solved.